सब्सक्राइब माई चैनल एंड प्रेस बेल आइकन टू गेट ऑल नोटिफिकेशन।
हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, नाउ वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट नेक्स्ट सेल डिवीजन व्हिच इज मियोसिस। यू नो दैट आफ्टर इंटरफेज इन द सेल साइकिल इंटरफेज हैपेंस एंड आफ्टर इंटरफेज सेल एंटर इनटू द एम फेज एंड इन द एम फेज सेल कैन डिवाइड बाय माइटोसिस और इट कैन डिवाइड बाय मियोसिस। So mitosis we done in the previous videos. Now we will discuss about the meiosis. So let's start with the meiosis. Meiosis is also known as reductional division. We can use the word that is reductional division. Why we are calling it reductional? क्यों हमने एक special name use किया इसके लिए? Why we calling it reductional division? Reductional division is means that in such type of division in the meiosis, the cells which are formed from the parent cells, they get the half number of chromosomes. Like in the mitosis, we have seen that the daughter cells have the same number of chromosomes that their parent cell. That's why that was known as equational division. But in the meiosis, the daughter cells get the half the amount of the chromosomes, half number of chromosomes, we can say that they get. That's why this division is known as reductional division. So meiosis is also known as reductional division. This division is first of all studied or discovered in the egg of sea urchin. So we can say that it is studied in the egg of sea urchin. That is the first cell we can say that where the meiosis was seen. And the scientists which are responsible for the discovery and for the explanation of the meiosis, that we explained that the number of cell chromosomes are reduced and they get halved in the total cell, that all thing was given by the scientist named von Behden. So von Behden was the scientist who explained or discovered the meiosis, but the term meiosis was given by the scientist Farmer and Moore. These are the two scientists who gave the term meiosis. So this is about the some historical background related with the meiosis. Now the cells which undergo into the meiosis, or we can say that cells which are doing the meiosis, these cells are known as meiocytes. So meiocytes are the cells which are going under the meiosis. Meiocytes are the cells, like in the case of animals, we can say that they have germ cells. These germ cells are diploid in number, and these germ cells do the meiosis by which they form the haploid gametes, and then these gametes fuse together to form a diploid zygote. So this type of the cells which do the meiosis, these cells are known as meiocytes. So here we can write that meiocytes are the, these are the cells which undergo meiosis. These cells are known as meiocytes. So this is about the meiocytes. Now let's discuss the type of meiosis. And first type of meiosis is gametic meiosis. Gametic meiosis. What happens in gametic meiosis? Here, the germ cells, like in this happens into the higher organism. We can write here that it happens in higher animals. Higher animals may present rahega. Higher organism, we can also write. It is present in higher organism. In this type of meiosis, the gametes are formed from the diploid cells. The, like in the case of animals, we know that germ cells are diploid in nature. Germ cells jo honge wo diploid nature ki hoti hai, and these diploid germ cells, they go to the meiosis and they form the haploid gametes. So here the haploid gametes, by this type of meiosis, haploid gametes are formed, and these haploid gametes, haploid means haploid male gamete and haploid female gamete. When these two haploid gametes fuse together, they form a diploid zygote. So in this way, we can say that if the meiosis happens to form the haploid gametes, then this meiosis is known as gametic meiosis. Second type of meiosis is zygotic meiosis. In the zygotic meiosis, this type of meiosis happens into the lower organism, like we can say that in the case of the algae like Cladophora, if you take the example, the lower animals, lower organism ke andar hoga, Here we can also write the organism, because it's not only the animals, lower organism. So this type of meiosis, zygotic meiosis, happen into the lower organism, like algae. If we take the example in which the parent body is haploid, this haploid parent body, they form the haploid gametes. When these haploid gametes fuse together at the time of reproduction, they form the diploid zygote. And this diploid zygote, further on, they go through the meiosis and they form the haploid cells. And these haploid cells now behave like an individual. They start their life as an individual. So when the meiosis happens into the zygote, and this zygote is diploid in nature, then this meiosis is known as zygotic meiosis. So we can say that diploid zygote इसके अंदर हो रहा है डिवीजन एंड डिप्लॉयड जाइगोट, इसमें मियोसिस होगा एंड दे फॉर्म द हैप्लोइड सेल्स. थर्ड टाइप ऑफ मियोसिस इज नॉन एज स्पोरिक मियोसिस. स्पोरिक मियोसिस लाइक दिस टाइप ऑफ मियोसिस हैपेंस इन टू द एग्जांपल्स, इफ वी टेक लाइक टेरिडोफाइट्स, वेयर द स्पोर्स आर फॉर्म एंड द स्पोर फॉर्मिंग सेल्स जो होती हैं, उन सेल्स को बोलते हैं स्पोर मदर सेल्स. These spore mother cells, they go through the meiosis and they form the spore. Spore mother cell meiosis karegi and they form the spores, and haploid spores are forming here. And in the case of plants, we can say that spore mother cell can be megaspore mother cell and microspore mother cells. Both type of spore mother cells are forming here, and these spore mother cells are go through the meiosis and they form the haploid cells. After that, they can form a new organism. So this is the type of meiosis which happens into the spore mother cells for the spore formation. That's why it is known as sporic meiosis. So here we can understand that this meiosis happens in different types of cells, by which we can differentiate or we can make the types of meiosis. Like if the meiosis is happening into the gamete, then we call it gametic meiosis, and in the diploid zygote do the meiosis to form the haploid cell, then we call it zygotic meiosis. And when the spore mother cells go through the meiosis to form the haploid spores, then we call it sporic meiosis. So that's about the type of meiosis. Now, before starting the complete process of meiosis, इससे पहले कि हम पूरा process detail में study करें, we just need to understand the complete steps of the meiosis in the form of flowchart. So let's discuss the meiosis in a flowchart. Now let's discuss how the meiosis happens. We will discuss all these steps in the form of flowchart here. After that, we'll take the details of all these stages. This meiosis process happens, or we can say that this meiosis completes into the two stages. The first stage is known as meiosis 1, and second stage is known as meiosis 2. One stage is meiosis 1. Again, it has karyokinesis and it has cytokinesis. Like in the case of mitosis, we discussed that mitosis mein pehle karyokinesis hota hai, uske baad cytokinesis hota hai. So same thing yahan pe bhi ho rahi hai. Jab cell meiosis 1 kar rahi hai, when it dividing first time into the meiosis process, it's passing through the meiosis 1, then first it do the karyokinesis and then it will pass through the cytokinesis. Same thing happens into the meiosis 2 also. First cell divide by the pass through the karyokinesis and then it will do the cytokinesis. So here we can see that cells are dividing two times. So when we have to make a differences between mitosis and meiosis, in the mitosis we just say that karyokinesis and cytokinesis. But if we were talking about the meiosis, जब हम meiosis के बारे में बात कर रहे हैं, यहाँ पे meiosis के अंदर karyokinesis और cytokinesis two times हो रहा है. That's why we use the word that is numbering, that is the 1 and 2. So we denote the numbers that this first meiosis and the stages of this first meiosis, or we can say that karyokinesis of this first meiosis is known as karyokinesis first, and this cytokinesis of meiosis 1 is known as cytokinesis 1. Same here in the meiosis 2, the karyokinesis will be known as karyokinesis 2 and the cytokinesis will be known as cytokinesis 2. So we have two phase stages, meiosis 1 and meiosis 2. In the meiosis 1, first of all karyokinesis 1 happens, then cytokinesis 1 or first will happen. In the karyokinesis first, the all the stages that was the same like the mitosis, why sub stages only like prophase, metaphase, anaphase and then telophase. So here also we give the numbering to make it differentiate from the mitosis. Yahan pe bhi humne number mention kiye hai. Here, the prophase in the karyokinesis, first the prophase will known as prophase 1, metaphase will known as metaphase 1, anaphase will known as anaphase 1, and the telophase will known as telophase 1. Same thing happen here in the karyokinesis 2, prophase 2, metaphase 2, anaphase 2, and the telophase 2. After that, cytokinesis 2 will happen. So this is the complete stages of the meiosis. In the case of meiosis, and especially that we, if we talk about the meiosis, it is done into the two stages, that is meiosis 1 and 2. In the meiosis 1, that prophase 1 of this meiosis, that is this process, we are talking about this stage, that is in the meiosis 1, the prophase 1 of the meiosis 1 is the very longest subphase, longest phase. Ye jo phase hoti hai, prophase first, ye bahut lumbi phase hoti hai. And this phase, this prophase 1 is further divided into the sub-phases. Isse hum kuch sub-phases mein divide karte hain. And these sub-phases have particular name. So let's discuss what are the name of these sub-phases of the prophase 1. The first phase is known as lactoting. Then after that the next will be the zygoting. Next pachyteen, or sometime we can call it pachyteen. कहीं पे आपको सब pachyteen या pachyteen किसी भी तरीके से आपको pronunciation मिल सकता है. This is a pachyteen. After that next stage will be diploteen. These all are the subphases of the prophase 1. We are talking about this prophase 1. And this prophase 1 completes into these subphases. Lactoteen, zygoteen, pachyteen, diploteen, and the last subphase is dikinesis. So these are the subphases of the prophase 1. So prophase 1 completes by passing through all these subphases. After that, the metaphase 1 happens, then anaphase 1, then telophase 1, and then karyokinesis 1. After that, cell will divide. It moves into the meiosis 2, where it divides their karyokinesis. It do karyokinesis 2 and then cytokinesis 2. So these are the subphases and subphases of the meiosis. Here, we need to understand one important thing, that when cell starts any division, before it enters into the anaphase, it prepares itself into the interphase. That we all know that before entering into the meiosis, jab cell yahan pe enter kar rahi hai, yahan enter karne se pehle cell ne interphase jo stage hai wo complete kar liya, means it has completed its G1, S and G2 phases. G1, S or G2, ye teen phase complete karke cell ne meiosis ke andar enter kiya hai, aur meiosis 1 mein enter kiya. Aur if we start with that, we can say that it enters into the prophase 1. After the interphase, it enters into the prophase 1. But what happens in the interphase? We all know that in the interphase, cell grows, cell grow karegi, and it do all the required preparation. Sabhi required preparation ho jayegi, and the DNA also gets duplicated. DNA duplication bhi ho jayega before it enters into the meiosis. After that, it will do karyokinesis, nucleus division ho jayega, cytokinesis ho jayega, and then cell has to move into the meiosis 2. Here, when cell enters from meiosis 1 to meiosis 2, jaise cell meiosis 1 complete karke meiosis 2 mein enter karti hai, before it enters into the meiosis 2, it takes a rest period. It takes some time to rest. Yahan pe ek phase aati hai, and this phase is known as interkinesis. So we can show it like that. After cytokinesis 1, cell will enter into this karyokinesis 2. But this stage, which we are all calling it the, that is the rest phase. This rest phase is known as interkinesis. And this interkinesis is the rest phase in which cell do the growth, means it's just take a rest, but no DNA duplication happen. You have to koi S phase nahi hota. Interkinesis phase means we can say that DNA is not duplicating again. Yahan pe fir se DNA duplication nahi ho raha before entering into the meiosis 2. So we can see that only cell makes its DNA copies one time, एंड इट डिवाइड्स टू टाइम्स. एक बार ही डीएनए डुप्लीकेट हो रहा है बट सेल डिवाइड हो रही है दो बार. फर्स्ट टाइम इट्स डिवाइडिंग बाय द मियोसिस वन, सेकंड टाइम इट इज डिवाइडिंग बाय द मियोसिस टू. एंड बिटवीन दीज मियोसिस वन एंड मियोसिस टू इट्स अ शॉर्ट रेस्ट स्टेज व्हिच इज नोन एज इंटरकाइनेसिस. एक इंटरकाइनेसिस स्टेज आती है एंड दिस इंटरकाइनेसिस हैज नो एस फेज. Means we can say there is no duplication of DNA happens in these between this meiosis 1 and meiosis 2. So this is about all the phases of the meiosis. If we take a example that how this complete process is happening, kaise ho raha hai? Suppose this is one meiosite. Meiosite means this is the cell which is going through the meiosis and it's diploid in number. Diploid ploidy hai means it has two sets of the chromosome. When it do this meiosis 1, here we can write that M1. It passes through the meiosis 1. It forms two daughter cells. It forms two daughter cells. And these daughter cells will have half the number of the chromosomes. Here the number of chromosomes get reduced. It get halved. And the daughter cells which are forming here, these are half number of chromosomes. So they are haploid in nature. This is the meiosis 1 by which two haploid cells are forming. These two haploid cells, after completing meiosis 1, they will enter into the meiosis 2. That's what we are talking about, that after that they will enter into the meiosis 2. So here we can write that this is the meiosis 2. The meiosis 2 will happen and these meiosis 2 will form two daughter cells. They will form two daughter cells. Let's make it clearly. It will make two daughter cells. So finally, we can say that here four daughter cells are forming. Four daughter cells jo hai yahan pe form ho rahi hai, and in these daughter cells again they have the same number of chromosomes. Here koi DNA duplication nahi hua tha. Same number DNA jo hoga ya chromosome number honge wo daughter cells mein transfer honge. So these cells will haploid in nature. They are similar to their parent cell. Now these are the parent cells for these daughter cells. Finally, four haploid cells are forming into the meiosis. Here, let's see. In the meiosis 1, the chromosomes number reduce. That's why this meiosis is known as reductional division. Isse hum bol sakte hain reductional division. But into the meiosis 2, we can say that there is no changes into the number of chromosomes. Same, haploid cells are forming by the haploid cells are formed from the haploid parent cell. No chromosomes number are changed. That's why this meiosis 2 is known as equational division. It is equational division like mitosis. So it's an equational division like mitosis. So it's just like a mitosis, meiosis 2 is similar to mitosis, where the same number of chromosomes are passed to the daughter cells. So this is the complete flow chart and all the phases and subphases of the meiosis. And we can say that meiosis completes into the two stages, meiosis 1 and meiosis 2. Now we will discuss all these phases. We will start from the prophase 1 and we'll discuss complete these subphases of the prophase 1 in the detail in our next video. So keep watching, keep studying and keep learning. Thank you.